Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's the moment you've been waiting over 2 years for. Just in case you've forgotten what pantomime is all about, don't forget that you need to boo the villains. Let's give it a go after three. One, two, three! Oh, come on! You can be much louder than that. Let's go again. One, two, three! Excellent! And don't forget to cheer the heroes. So make as much noise as you can. After three, one, two, three! Fantastic! Now put your hands together, sing and dance along as we present Snow White and the Seven Dwarves.
Funny. Let me have a look at you. Give yourself a round of applause, won't you, ladies and gentlemen? You're much more repulsive than the audience we had yesterday. Anyway, this is a tale of a woman's need to be a beauty and indeed to be the fairest in the land. In this I'll lend a helping hand. Who is this woman so vain and weak? It is the queen of whom... Shut up! Do you mind? Watch it, you. I'll poison your ice cream. Where was I before I was rudely interrupted by another dwarf? Who is this woman so vain and weak? It is the queen of whom we speak. I have one very simple task. I'll do everything the queen may ask. And in return for being at her beck and call, I shall be the most powerful wizard of them all! Oh, yes, I will! Oh, yes, I will! Oh, no, I won't! I knew it, you're all thick.
Mirror, mirror in my hand, who is the fairest in the land?
You're currently the fairest in the land, but soon there will be one far more grand. There's a young girl who is at number one, and with her beauty, your plan may be undone. She's a young star who will continue to shine bright. She's well known to you. Her name's Snow White.
Snow White, my stepdaughter, but Prince Michael is due today to choose his bride-to-be.
I'm sure he'll choose you, my majesty. After all, the most beautiful in the land.
Yes, you're right. But what if he chooses Snow White?
Fear not. Your personality and beauty will woo him.
Yes, but he may be fickle and see her youth. I should have got rid of her the day her father died. Then none of this would be happening. See to it that I marry Prince Michael.
Hurry now,
immediately, if not sooner.
Hurry now, my queen. Prince Michael will be here soon, and we don't want you being late for your wedding, do we? And as for you, horrible lot, you won't stop me from being... Shut up. From being the most powerful wizard in the kingdom. And should you try, I'll turn you into something so grotesque they wouldn't even let you into Atherston.
I better go get some decorations for the co-op. See you later.
Did I surprise you?
Just a little.
Do you know, this place has changed so much.
And so have you.
Well, it's been a while, hasn't it, Snow White?
A while? You haven't even replied to my letters.
Look, I know. I'm sorry. I've just been so busy in Litchfield and with all the lockdowns. I know we tried to play a few of those quizzes on Zoom. Didn't really work, the correction's terrible, but I'm here now, that's all that matters.
Well, I'll let you off this time. Oh, it's so good to see you. I've got so much to tell you. Muddles can't wait to meet you. I've been telling him everything. And I've got to show you the castle grounds. They've changed so much since we were last here.
Oh, well, no time like the present. Shall we go?
Oh, yeah.
Come on then.
Thanks, Joseph. Oh, I don't know where to park on a Sunday with the council round here, you know. Oh, hello, everybody! I said, hello, everybody! Fabulous. My name this year is Nurse Nelly, and I'm the palace nurse. I am sorry I'm late. There was an accident on the A5. I think it's called Myloak. Dreadful. Yes. I look after Snow White. Well, I looked after her. She's 21 now and probably doesn't need me anymore. Aww. Oh, well, it's sadder than that. Aww. Better, yes. Now, it's difficult being me. I'm getting older, you see. When a girl's in her 20s, she's like Africa. Beautiful and unspoiled. And when a girl's in her 40s, she's like America. Rich, elegant. When a girl's in her 60s, she's like Nuneaton. Everyone knows where it is, but no one wants to go there. Anyway, best be off. See you later, boys and girls. Come back here. Hello. Hello, boys and girls. Oh, come on. You can be louder than that. I said hello, boys and girls. Oh, that's better. Now allow me to introduce myself. My name is Muddles, and I'm the Royal Palace Jester here. But guess what? This year, I've got a gang! Come on, gang! That's it. Right, everybody, clap your hands! Come on, up just as we rehearsed. No showing off. Yes, I can see you. Don't upstage me again. And you, your trouble. Right then. Are we ready? Exactly as we rehearsed. Oh, medals! Let's see if we can do it. I said a hip, pop, a hip. A hippie to the hip, hip, pop. You can't stop the booty to the bam, bam. Booty say up, drop the booty to the booty of the rhythmy beat. Now what you hear is not a test. I'm rapping to the beat. It's me, my gang, and my shoes. We're gonna try to move your feet. See, I am Muddles, and I'd like to say hello to the front, to the back, to the middle, and even to those from Glasgow. To say, hop, hoppy, hoppy to the booty. You can't stop the booty. You won't stop the booty. You can't stop. You won't stop. Now time to do the dance solo. Let's go. What you doing? I told you not to show up. This is just showing off. It's my moment. Ow! Lockdown hasn't been nice. Stop it, stop it. Jack, no, can you? Muddles! Give it up for the fantastic Muddles gang. We've got Michelle, Rachel, Adele, Chantel, and Keith. You look different on your headshot. Get off, you troublemaker. Oh, boys and girls, today is very exciting. You see, today is Snow White's birthday, and I am so in love with Snow White. Oh, it's sweeter than that. Aww. Yes, and you see, because she's so pretty and modest and funny, this year I thought I would go above and beyond, so I've got her a really nice present. Would you like to see what I've got her? Well, it's over here in this box, and it is a very, very cute little teddy bear. Aww. I can't wait to give it to her. Hopefully, she'll marry me as soon as I give her this teddy bear. But I could do with your help. I'm going to leave this teddy bear over here in the box, ready for when Snow White needs it. But I need you to look after it. Can you do it for me? Yeah. Oh, fantastic. So now it's time for a bit of audience patronizer participation. So whenever anyone comes over and starts to look at this box, I need you to all put your hands in the air, wave them around and shout, Muddles! Right, so let's give it a go after three. You ready? One, two, three! Muddles! Let's do it like it's Christmas time. It's not April. Here we go. Let's try it one more time. Oh, oh, what's this present? One, two, three! Muddles! Yeah! We're getting there. Well, I spend a lot of Act 2 off stage. So, I may be backstage. So, I'll go backstage and I'll count down and then we'll give it a go. Ooh. Hello, sweeties. Ah, oh, is that a gift for me from an admirer?
Whoa,
you get away from that box.
Sorry, it's been a while since I've had my hands on a big package. She knows. How are you, Muddles? How's life? How's your job searching going?
Oh, Mum, it's been very difficult. You see, it's been a while since the Queen furloughed me. Aww. I know, so I've had to retrain in the meanwhile. So I've now became a COVID-19 safety marshal. Woo! Yeah, I've got a career in this for years. I'm going to stop it.
So what do you have to do?
Well, the first role of a COVID-19 safety marshal, I need to make sure that everyone has sanitised their hands. So if you just show me your hands, please. Let's check those fingers.
Oh, some dirty hands down here.
Don't worry, I've come prepared. You see, I've got some sanitiser.
You shouldn't have sat in the front row, John.
Show me those hands. Let's just get them sorted. There we go. Show those hands. Safety first, we never compromise.
But Muddles,
yeah.
What about those people in the middle, particularly over there, that are feeling very left out?
A good COVID safety marshal always comes prepared. Show me those hands. Let's just make sure we get everyone. Get those hands out. Very good.
But Muddles.
In the eye.
He's got a good social. Blimey.
Well, the panto sounded good, but I couldn't see it, dear.
It's a good job I filled in that risk assessment form, wasn't it?
He's drenched.
But Muddles. Well, look at with the energy crisis, why have a shower at home when you can come here?
He's one step away from getting a sponge out. Don't know what you're laughing at.
But what about those people on the rake seating who are thinking, I'm missing out on this fun?
I'm sorry, guys, but I didn't want to leave you out. This is where the big toys come out.
But that's not going to reach up there.
You're right, Mum. So this year the budget is stretched. So whenever I press this giant big red button, there we go. Come on in, boys. Get them on the rakes. Get them all. Get them all. Good job, team. Good job.
Oh, no.
It's brilliant.
Shield! Oh my word!
Very good.
It's like
give Muddles his giant round of applause. And now we're all safe.
They thought they were back at SeaWorld. That's going. Oh my.
Chuck him a fish.
Now, Muddles.
Yes.
Back to the script.
Back to the script.
Do you like my dress? Kick them out and you leave your number on the side.
Mum, I love your dress. Where was it from?
It's from George.
Asda?
No, the crossdresser from the White Lion.
Oh. Boys and girls, I forgot to tell you some very important news. Over the lockdown, Mum was actually given a new title.
Oh, yes.
She's not just Nurse Nelly. This year, she's known as Dame Nurse Nelly. Ooh. Yeah.
Well, to give myself my full title, I'm Dame Nurse Nelly, OBE, CBE, MBE, BBC, ITV, QBC, ABC, CBBC, IBS, NAC.
Sorry, what does NAC stand for?
Not a clue. It's difficult being me, boys and girls, because I am on the hunt for a man.
Ooh!
Yes, in fact, I've been married before.
You haven't?
I have. I've been married 16 times.
16?
Yes, I did exactly as the vicar said. 4 richer, 4 poorer, 4 better, 4 worse. It's true. My last wedding was at St. Editha's round the corner, and he asked me what I'd like as a wedding present. And I said I'd really like a ship in a bottle. But he was hard of hearing. It didn't go too well. I don't know how he got it in there. I'm still thinking about it. And the one before that, he was dreadful. He treated me like a piece of meat.
Oh.
He was a vegan, never touched me. Terrible it was, terrible.
Horrific. What have you been up to today, Mum?
Oh, busy day. In fact, I went to the post office and I found a few letters.
Oh, some letters? Of our friends. Did you buy anything while you were there, Mum?
Oh, yes, I bought loads of things. Would you like any sweets, Muddles?
Oh, I'd love some sweets.
Now, would you like any sweets? Go on then, throw some sweets
out. We'll go over here.
It is Easter after all.
We'll go over there. We'll go right back there. Incoming missiles, watch out!
What about the chocolate eggs? Can we throw them?
No, not quite.
Oh!
That's the Invisible Man!
Yes. Don't worry, they're very COVID safe. Just have a suck and pass it on.
Oh!
Fabulous. And we've got some friends in Muddles tonight. We've got some friends in.
We've got friends in? Who we got?
I don't know. Who've we got?
Well,
you did that one.
Oh, give me a sec. Carry on.
Oh, we've got. Somebody. Tony, Pam, Tyler and Charlie, they've come all the way from
Milo. It'll be nice when it's finished. Where's Dan and Jasmine? Yeah, is that you? Talk to me.
Oh, there we go.
And it says, and children. Do they have names? Oh, hello, nice to see you. Welcome to the Tamworth Pantomime Company. If it's your first, it might be your last. Where's Julie and Dennis? Where are you?
Oh, over here.
How are you? And who's this? Who have we got here?
Ellie and Barry.
How are you, Ellie and Barry? Where are you from, Barry?
Ask Joseph.
Joseph? No, I'm asking you. Swaddling Co. Oh, what a shame.
Really sorry.
We've got a ski place as well, but ours has got snow. Maybe you'll get some snow one day. Oh, where's Vicky and Kenny? Are we doing the whole audience?
We're going through.
Hey, Vicky and Kenny. Hi there. Where are you from, Kenny?
Tewkesbury.
Sorry?
Tewkesbury.
No, I heard you. I was just sorry. Tewkesbury. And they've got no pantos in Tewkesbury in Easter.
Oh.
That's a shame. Who have you got in medals?
Well, I'm trying to decipher the handwriting. Yeah. It says Angie.
Angie?
Oh, this one took me twice, had I, actually. bit of a damp start to a panto. Angie can't be here today because she's 111. Ooh. It's 111th birthday.
She must be celebrating a birthday.
She must be 111. That deserves a round of applause. Well done, Angie. Fantastic.
Wait a minute. Muddles?
Yeah?
She's not 111.
What?
She's ill. ILL says she's ill. 111. So stupid, aren't you? And we got some letters here as well from your pen pals. You know, the old girls used to fancy online.
Oh, I used to love all the girls online.
So we got this one's from Claire.
Oh, Claire. Now, boys and girls, Claire had the most incredible hair. It's beautiful.
This one's from Grace.
Oh, Grace. She had the most amazing face.
And this one's from Annie. What do you remember about Annie?
Well, Annie had the most spectacular smile. Lovely smile.
A beaming smile.
Beaming, butter wouldn't melt.
Now, that's the shout outs done. Very good.
On with the lines.
On with the lines. Now, boys and girls, the Jubilee's coming up, so I've prepared myself. I'm wearing my very special Union Jack knickers.
Ooh. Are they comfortable?
They are now. I've removed the flagpole.
But, Mum, I do need your advice. You see, you know I'm in love with Snow. It's Prince Michael of Lichfield fame!
Never mind that. Come on. Show your manners.
Salam, salam, salam.
You don't have to do that for a prince.
False alarm, false alarm, false alarm.
Right. I'm guessing that you're Muddles.
And I'm guessing you read the script.
And I'm Dame Nurse Nelly.
Very nice to meet you, Dame Nurse Nelly. Now, Snow White's just popped back over to Ventura, so I thought I'd come back here and just get her some flowers.
Oh, you like Snow White, don't you?
I love Snow White.
Yes, no worries.
Shut up! Get excited, it's not real. My queen. There's Ponzi Prince Michael, your suitor. You woo him, and I'll take care of Snow White.
Hello, my loyal subjects. It is I, Queen Dragonella.
Boo!
Get up.
Oh, you can boo all you like. I like my boos before a wedding. Today marks a very special occasion. Prince Michael of Lichfield will be here to choose his wife-to-be. This is a marriage that will unite two kingdoms of Lichfield and Tamworth. Prince Michael, I assume you've made your decision already.
thank you, Your Royal Highness. Yes, I have made a decision. You see, ever since I was young, me and this girl, we've had a very close bond. So I hope that when I do ask her to marry, she will, of course, say yes.
Yes?
Yes, yes. Let's skip the church and go straight to the honeymoon. I've booked the presidential at Christopher's.
But no, wait, oh. I didn't mean...
Yes, yes, yes. Everyone is invited. We'll have a big ball.
Oh,
yay! Yes.
I love a big ball, yes.
Stop it. Especially the buffet. Oh, yes. The quiche.
Oh.
The vol-au-vent.
Ooh.
And those little wrinkly things on sticks.
What, pensioners?
Come on, let's get the food prepared. See you later, boys and girls.
And to think we were worried about Snow White.
Remember the mirror, Your Majesty. The mirror is never wrong. Snow White is still the fairest in the land.
Don't I know it? But I want to be the fairest in the land. Sort it out.
Just say the word. And it will be done.
Sounds like you were going to kill her. You wasn't going to kill her, was you?
I'll do whatever it takes to ensure that you marry Poncy Prince Michael. Shut up.
Come, my lover. Our chamber awaits.
No, I'm just I still need to speak to some people in the market, so I'll be back to the castle soon.
Okay, so long, sweetie.
And so it starts. My plan comes together. I will ensure Queen Dragonella marries Poncy Prince Michael, and you ugly lot are not going to do anything to stop me, are you?
No.
Oh, no, you're not.
No,
I can't be bothered to do that again. Shut up.
Does he always talk to himself?
Yeah.
So strange. Oh, what am I going to do now?
Oh, here you are.
Snow White. Sorry, I was just... easy for you.
Oh, how sweet. I'm sorry I'm late. I was checking out the new home bargains in Ventura, but the traffic was just terrible. But you know when something just feels right? The birds are tweeting a beautiful song, the sun is shining, and you're here. It's perfect.
Yeah, I wish it was.
Well, what's the matter? You seem a little flustered.
So there's been some sort of misunderstanding, and your stepmother thinks that I'm here to marry her. Oh, I'm
what?
Not... I'm not here to marry her. Don't worry. She's gone and organised the ball and everything, so should really go speak to her about it.
But what about her magician? He's pure evil through and through.
Yeah, well, I mean, he's just stood here talking to himself.
He does that a lot.
Yeah. Look, I've fought dragons and things. He's not a problem.
Well, he's horrid. They're horrid. They'll lock you up, or worse, they'll make you work for the council.
Ugh.
It's not worth it.
You're worth it.
Sorry?
You are worth it. Can I tell you something, Snow White? Look, I've been looking forward to this day for a very long time because I was hoping that you would spend the rest of your life with me.
If my stepmother was to ever find out, she's capable of anything when he's around.
Oh, don't worry about her. I'm going to go right to the castle and sort that out. It's going to be fine.
But what if something...
No buts and no ifs. We're going to get through this together. I'll never let you go, Snow White, I promise.
Well, you better get back before she starts questioning where you are.
You're right.
Goodbye, Prince Michael.
I'll see you soon, okay?
Yeah.
Stop that! Stop that! 2 metres! Get apart, get apart.
Nurse,
social distancing.
Nurse,
no, we won't have that.
Nurse Nelly, that's not a thing anymore. Boris said so.
What?
Anyway, you better get back and I'll go and put these in water.
I do get confused, boys and girls, all these COVID rules. It's been a difficult couple of years, hasn't it? In, out, shake it all about. COVID vaccine passports, I never know what's going on. Boris put the country into lockdown and we stayed at home. Did too many quizzes on Zoom and on our mobile phone. Fever and persistent cough. I had a lot. Slogans and mixed messages. Which of these have you forgot? Happy birthday! Wash your hands and sing that tune. Stay home, save lives. Boris quickly changed his tune. Get your vaccine. Two jabs and we're free. Get boosted now. You've had two jabs, so why not three or four or five or six or a vaccine every single day of your life? Now don't leave your house, but you can leave your house if you have to leave your house for exercise. Don't go to work, but you can go to work if you can't go to work, but please work from home. Don't go shopping, just essential shopping, but don't go shopping unless it's for toilet rolls. Don't meet more than six people unless they're in your bubble, and don't sit on that park bench. Test and trace and isolate and face masks every single day. Patrick, balance, Chris, Whitty, and not forgetting JVT. Tier 1, Tier 2 and Tier 3, we're all in tears, you and me. Matt Hancock, remember him, made the rules up on a whim. Kiss that girl, lost his job and his wife, he's a not very good person. Don't leave your house, but you can leave your house if you have to leave your house for exercise. Don't go to work, but you can't go to work if you can go to work, but please work from home. Don't go shopping, just essential shopping. Just don't go shopping unless it's for toilet rolls. Don't meet more than six people unless they're in your bubble. But don't sit there. Eat out to help out. Thanks, Rishi. Is it a work meeting or a party? You can bring your own cake and booze and wine and cheese to Downing Street. A COVID symptom is a loss of smell and taste. So it is clear that I've got the pantomimus.
Thank you. Thank you. It's so confusing, boys and girls. Bring on the next pandemic.
Get a life. Take some medicine. Coffin in the front. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the evilest of them all?
Well, I've given it considerable thought and whittled it down to a top 10. Would you like the countdown?
The first three will suffice, thank you.
In third place, Will Smith.
Oh. Never.
In second place, Piers Morgan.
Ugh, him.
I would have preferred something a little more topical, but respectful choice nevertheless.
And who is the evilest of them all?
It is you, O evil one.
You see, my queen, there's nothing to worry about with regard to Snow White. You got all the power, the wealth, and now the prince. Is somebody got a toy in here and squeezed it? Eow! What is it, an Ewok? Oh, it's a baby. Where did you buy that from? We're not selling them outside, are we? Yeah. Stop squeezing it. Shut up. Where was I now?
He was about to kiss my hand.
Was I?
But I want to be the fairest in the land. Where is my prince? I do not enjoy this hanging around. I do hope he's not with Snow White.
What's that over there, glittering, calling me over?
Oh, get away from that, you! Oh, my word, he's a bit big and hairy.
He's a fool.
That is for Snow White, not for you.
Oh, Muddles, you're so obsessed with Snow White. What is it she has that I don't?
Youth, beauty, a personality.
How rude. I am youthful and I am beautiful.
Yeah, and you're a liar.
My queen, I think I have a plan which will go to your desires. Why don't we get Puddles over there to distract Snow White? Therefore, you've not got to worry about her stealing Poncy Prince Michael's heart.
Snow White had never fall for Muddles.
Ah, we'll teach him everything he knows.
Muddles!
Yeah?
You do really like Snow White, don't you?
That's a secret I couldn't tell you.
Have you had a girlfriend?
Yeah, loads.
We're talking to you, shut up. Have you?
Yeah, loads.
How many? One?
More than that.
Two?
Well, not that many. Don't embarrass me.
You see, Muddles, it's all about posture.
Oh, yeah.
It's the way you hold yourself.
Okay.
Not literally.
Oh.
Listen to your queen.
Shoulders back.
Chin up. In your case, chin's up.
Stomach in.
Buttocks clenched.
Knees together. Now, how does that make you feel?
A bit like a pregnant T-Rex, if I'm honest.
Yes, it'll come. Just needs a lot of practice.
Muddles.
Yeah.
A handsome magician like me doesn't, shut up, doesn't have problems with the opposite sex.
Yeah?
Unfortunately, you're just a jester and you need all the help you can get.
But I really like Snow White, like really like it. I've even been trying a new type of deodorant just to woo her.
Ball type?
No, for under the arms. The instructions though, right? They say take off top, push up bottom. Don't think I've done it right. I haven't been able to ride a bike for weeks. I struggled.
As I was saying, Muddles.
Yeah.
It's all about the atmosphere.
Okay.
Imagine a romantic meal for two. The table. The music. You undo a few buttons. You brush what hair you've got back. You lean over. You go for the kill. And you say, pass me the treacle, sweetie.
See. Pass me the honey.
Right. There was less buttons in rehearsal. Pass me the jam, tart.
No, no, there's no hope. There's no hope.
What?
The man's a fool.
Was it something I said? Just following your lead. Sorry. Just trying to be romantic.
It's a wonder you never got a slap.
Right, let's try something a little more sweeter, perhaps. Pass me the sweets, sweeter.
Oh,
pass me the chili. Patty. Get ready.
Pass me the milk, cow.
No, no, no. This isn't working.
Sorry. Give it time.
We can't give it time because here she comes now.
No time like the present. Remember, posture.
Yes, remember, keep it cool.
Okay.
Now. Say something really nice. Something you actually like. Not jam tart, cow, milk. Something affectionate. Right, let's leave him to it, magician. Good luck.
Confidence. Remember.
Remember. I have to say, boys and girls, it's very nice for the magician and queen to help me woo Snow White. I'm sure they have innocent intentions. Now remember what they said. Keep your cool, have your posture, don't embarrass yourself.
Oh, hello, Muddles. Are you okay? Have you been on the Haribos again?
Oh, the Tantastics hit me differently.
Oh, what's this?
Oh, Snow White, you don't want any of that. That little present there is for the girl I'm in love with.
Oh, Muddles, that's so sweet.
Oh, now stand over there while I prepare the scene. Right then, I remember what they said. Posture, hair back, buttons, chest out. Atmosphere, lights. Oh, Harry, can you just dim the lights a little bit? Make it a little bit seductive. Yeah. Maybe find a lighting state that makes me look good. Really, Harry? Just give me a spotlight or something. Come on.
Oh.
Literally centre stage. Get out my spotlight. Oh. Right. So we got the collar. It's his first day and he thinks he can do... Bring this down. I've got a good exposition line coming next. Come on. Lights. Can I have some normal lights, Harry? Give me some normal lights. Normal. Oh, I tell you, Tony, you never want to work with a new technician on his first day. What is wrong with you? I'm going to turn this one off. And scene. Lights. Music. Snow White?
Yes, Muddles.
Got a favour to ask you.
Okay.
Pass me the Kit Kat, Chunky.
Muddles! If you wanted a Kit Kat, you could just ask nicely.
I did exactly what was asked of me, and now I've gone and upset my one true love, Snow White. You want to let me out of
So, what's it like to be in love again? I can almost smell my prince. So, how did it go with Snow White?
It is dreadful. I think I upset her as she got.
He's an idiot. My queen, I have a plan which I think you'll like. We need to dispose of Snow White.
Dispose?
Yes.
Killer!
Killer?
Are you deaf? Shut up, will you? Will you take a tranquilizer or something?
But
take a Valium.
I wouldn't want to banish my beautiful reputation.
We'll get the aid of somebody to do it for you.
And who would want to kill the fairest in the land?
What we need is somebody so stupid he wouldn't even be able to get into Glasgow.
What if anybody found out?
If anybody found out, his fingerprints would be all over the crime scene. I mean, who'd believe that?
Hello, boys and girls! Do you like the outfits? Going to a party later and the invite said smarty casual. You okay, Muddles? What's the matter with you? Is it the IBS playing up again?
My queen.
What has happened to you?
Ha! Two for the price of one! I'll hypnotise those two idiots to go deep, deep into the forest. Kidnap Snow White and take her there. Once she's there, they can kill her.
Does he know we can hear him?
Get them.
Nurse Nelly, Muddles.
Yes?
Yes?
I have a very important job for you both.
Okay. I'm sure I don't know what it is, but let's have a listen.
Right. All I need you to do is repeat everything we say.
Repeat everything you say.
Yes, everything we say.
Yes, everything we say.
No, I haven't started yet.
No, I haven't started yet.
I said I haven't started yet. No, not that.
No, not that.
Oh, stop being stupid.
Oh, stop being stupid.
I hate you both.
Well, I hate you both.
May I?
Look into my eyes. Listen to my voice.
That makeup's a funny choice.
Is that a Christmas bauble?
Shut up, bup-bup. You will do everything I say. You will kidnap Snow White.
Why are you laughing?
Because she's normally like this anyway. You will kidnap Snow White.
We're not under yet.
Okay. Well, pay attention then. Listen to my voice very carefully. Look me in the eyes. You will take Snow White.
Oh my word!
Killer, that's a bit dark, isn't it? Wouldn't get that in Swanley, Kate, would you, kill her?
Fine.
Or is a panto?
So go now. Go. Find Snow White. Go. Hi ho, hi ho. It's off to kill we go. Hi ho. Hi ho.
Can we stop off at McDonald's drive-thru on the way?
So my plan begins to take form. And none of you ugly lot are going to stop me, are you? Oh, no, you're not! Yes, you are! I'm definitely going to poison your ice creams again. I mean, yeah.
What daughter's birthday for years, only to have my stepmother come in and try and marry the love of my life. Prince Michael, what am I going to do?
Snow White! Oh! Snow White, I'm really sorry.
I can't believe it. You're soon to be married and to my stepmother, of all people.
No, I said I was going to change all of that. Look, I just haven't been able to get over to the castle yet. I promise I'm going to sort it out.
How?
Well, I do have another idea. Maybe we could just, you know, run away together.
Run away?
Yeah.
I can't.
Why not? It could be some sort of adventure.
That's easy for you to say. It's not that easy.
Well, look, your stepmother's running the kingdom. You've got no family left here, so I don't see why we couldn't just leave.
Well, I couldn't leave Nurse Delia Muddles. And it's not that easy, not when the two most powerful people in your kingdom hate you.
No, but we'll change that.
How?
I don't know, we'll just fix it.
You're a prince, it's easy for you to say. I have so many rules I have to obey.
Yeah, but it's not easy being a prince either. I have dreams.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting there for me, that I call my own.
That's nice.
Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, and it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy.
We need you to come with us.
What?
I said we need you to come with us.
Where are we going?
Somewhere nice. Just the new Costa Drive through Ventura. Oh. They do a nice latte.
Boys and girls, I don't think I want to go with them. Should I? No. No.
Oh, yes, we should. Oh, yes, we should. judgy.
What is our life?
I'm not going with you.
Get him an house.
What? I could, Mum Blake. Come on, love.
Get off me. Look, how are you this strong? Where's Michael? Help me.
Stop off at Nando's.
Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Halt and dwarves, it's nearly home time.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, Prof.
It's about time we got home. We've been up since the early hours.
Early? Amateur.
We have to be up early. It's the most productive part of the day. The early bird catches the worm.
Ew, I don't want no worms.
Well, there ain't no worms. It's a figure of speech.
What?
Hate my job.
We have to be up early to get the best out of the mine.
Yours?
Mine?
Whose?
It's brilliant!
It's a good job we got up early.
Although, I do think we should just work afternoons.
How lazy.
It has its benefits. Maybe we should try a 4-day week.
4 days? 4 days?
Yeah.
I mean, I've got to spend 3 of my days off with you lot.
Well, you currently spend 7 of them.
Think of all that time I could catch up on sleep.
What do you think?
I don't know.
Well, I can't even make a decision. Come on, commit to it, lad.
Enough of this. Time for a roll call.
What's a roll call?
Are you stupid?
No, I'm plunky, silly.
Right, what? Well,
we'll have none of that, thank you. Where do you think we are? Glasgow? As you were.
Giggly.
Cranky.
Plonky!
Oh!
What do you mean you're too scared to say your name? You've been living with us all these years and you're still too scared?
Come on, spit it out. I don't want to be out here all day.
Dozy! I'm here. I'm not asleep.
Well done, Flaky. We got there in the end, buddy. So, we've got Plonky, Flaky, Dozy, Giggly, Cranky...
Kevin.
Right. Why does he get a normal name?
And why is he always so cranky?
Because it's my name. Everyone else's name represents them.
It's true.
Anyway, I have been trying to change. I've been in a positive thinking course.
How was it?
Dreadful.
Right. So we've got Plonky, Flaky, Kevin, Dozy, Giggly, Cranky, and me, Prof. Right, we're all here. Let's have an early finish. Let's lock up the mine and let's call it a day.
Prof, why would you call it a day when it's a mine?
It's ours.
It's mine.
Brilliant! Get it? Mine?
Plonky, not again.
Did I hear an early finish?
Who gave him the airy bow? Frankie, sort him out, will you? Right, you've all worked extra hard today. The quicker we get to the mine and lock it up, the quicker we can get home and have a nice relax. And I've got a surprise for you. We can watch The Chase.
Blimey, come on then.
This way, Snow White.
Come on, nearly there.
What is wrong with you two?
I'm sorry, Snow White, but now it's time to kill you!
What?
I said, but now it's time to kill you!
Ow.
Snow White, where are we?
You were going to hurt me.
Hurt you? I'd never hurt you, Snow White.
But I would.
What?
Get out! Take that! Oh, she's still under the spell! And that!
Snow White! Snow White!
You keep Snow White's name out of your filthy mouth!
I felt like I was back at the Oscars.
I think she's still under the spell.
I wasn't under the spell. I was out the first time you slapped me, you silly boy. You are stupid. Absolutely stupid. You're S-T-U-P-I-D. Stupid. You hear me?
What did you say, sorry?
I said you're stupid. S-T-U-P-I-D. Stupid.
Well, if I'm stupid, you know what that makes you?
What?
A disciplinarian.
A what?
A D-I-S-P-I. Sit, I've gone wrong.
Get off me.
D-I-S.
Stop it, you.
Stop it.
What's the matter with you?
Nearly left me earpiece.
At least you didn't lose your pants.
Serves me right for eating candy floss on a roller coaster.
What is going on?
Oh, Snow White, it's the evil queen and the evil magician.
Oh, they sent us here to kill you.
They hypnotized us.
I was hypnotized by his swinging thing. It was back and forward. I couldn't take my eyes off it. You know what I mean?
So she sent you two to get rid of me?
Oh, she wants more than get rid of you. She wants you dead, gone, removed from the face of the earth.
Just like that Sue Gray reported to Partygate. Vanished. Kicked. Oh, no.
That must be the Queen. Quick, hide!
Who's that? Ah.
To the cottage.
To the cottage.
Get in the cottage, Mum. It'll be safe in here.
Special effects. It's like the Hippodrome, isn't it? Where's my...
We've got Tom.
I meant to be hiding behind a... stupid stage crew. Carry on. Where do we get them from? Hide behind a bush.
Come on, dwarves! Bradley's gonna be on in 5 minutes! We have a couple that are a bit leggy. Plonky, I thought I told you to close the door when we left this morning.
Hang about, I did.
Well, what's that smell then?
There is a certain kind of stench in here. It smells like...
Oh, maybe it's got some wildlife crawling from Gemini.
Well, you never know. Dwarves, split up and get rid of whatever that is. That lamp wasn't there this morning, was it?
It was meant to be a lamp, but I couldn't find one, so I used this bush. And yes, it's always been here.
And this bed wasn't so lumpy.
How cheeky.
Be quiet, they'll find us.
I'm just copying you, you're talking.
Shut up!
Bush!
Did the lamp and the bed just speak?
It's not a lamp, it's a bush, because they didn't bring a lamp on stage for me to hide behind. So I hid behind the bush and it didn't speak, no.
So short.
Can you keep the noise down, please?
Oh
my
gosh.
Who are you?
Get out of our house.
I know it looks like we broke in, but we can explain.
It was the evil queen. Queen Dragonella.
Sure, I hate her.
I think I'm gonna faint! Ah, gosh!
Oh my gosh!
Lord!
Is he well?
If possible, we could potentially hide here.
Just until things blow over.
But there's only 7 beds.
We could make bunk beds!
That sounds like fun! Oh, spending the night with 7 short, hairy men. It's like a dream. It's like a night at the Castle Hotel.
We haven't even introduced ourselves. The name's Prof, and this is my band of 7 dwarves.
The seven dwarves, the famous seven dwarves. Who'd have thunk it, eh?
Blimey, he can count.
You know, Prof, I always say there's three types of people in this world. Those that can count and those that can't.
Oh, take it back.
Oh, it's exciting, but seven people. That must have been terribly awkward during the rule of six. When you went down the Longwood for a meal, did one of you have to wait in the car park?
Nah, Kevin used to stay at home. He prefers Wetherspoons anyway.
Well, I'm Snow White.
I'm Muddles.
And I'm Dame Nurse Nelly.
And we tried to kill some...
Kill some time by looking at this beautiful house with all the furniture. Fabulous.
So, we know it's really cheeky, but could we stay?
Yes, we can book the place on Airbnb.
Oh, I'd have to have a chat with the team.
Oh, come on then, Mum. I hope they say yes. If they say yes, we can go to interval.
I'm so excited.
We've had a chat, and we've decided that we could do with a bit more help around here.
Well, we'll do whatever we can to help.
So, you can stay.
Hooray!
You know, this could be quite fun. We don't get to see many people around here, do we? We could play some board games. Or even have a little dance.
That would be alright, actually. Blimey.
I haven't seen him this excited in a very long time.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the world, I'll turn it inside out. Yeah, cause I'm hanging out with Snow White.
Hello.
And Nurse Nelly.
So don't stop me now.
You're having a really good time, isn't
it? Don't stop me, cause I'm having a good time. I'm having a good time.
I'm so excited, but I love a
singular. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity.
Yeah.
I'm a racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go. There's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky. Yeah, 200 degrees. That's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I'm gonna make a supersonic ball out of you.
Me?
Stop me now.
I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball.
Such a good time. I'm having